consider are these. It's almost 37 years since we had the first synod in 1990. I remember in a gathering like this, at that time it was only for the clergy, it was held at the seminary. The issues are very different. Communion in the hand was a new thing. I remember one of the priests asking Archbishop Martha what was his policy of communion in the hand. Those are the issues of the time. That's a long time. So at that time and today, a lot of changes in terms of church, liturgy, and the social context has taken place over the 27 years. And so we need a new diocesan pastoral care. Second, we are facing new challenges of rapid social cultural changes, and the more current ones have to do with climate change and the impacts of globalization. And the church needs to be able to talk to these issues, to make a relevant, practical response. Number three, we need to update our Catholics with the current thinking of the church. There are some of us older people. Some of you were born during the transition of the Vatican I to Vatican II. Some still in the seminary, but some their understanding of what church is and how to pray is, probably the, it's got to do with the devotions. Today we are trying to be more rooted in the Word of God. So, you know, this we need to update our understanding of the church. And as I said, we are blessed with religious congregations, and so we need to instill a stronger communion within the church. And finally, in our visitation with the bigger chapel, we also see the need to be together in our pastoral programs. We notice that pastoral programs, catechism, all differ from parish to parish, and depending on the catechism, who the priest is, whether he's a religious, and we need to bring this together so that we are all on the same journey, at least in terms of our pastoral program. So those are some of the reasons for me calling together this year. Finally, okay, so to achieve that, one of the important phases of a synod is catechism, renewal, to update ourselves in terms of the church's understanding and how we see church and theology today. So today's session and in the weekend for the lay leaders, we will cover these sessions. So the first four sessions, sorry, the first two have got to do with updating ourselves. And that word that was used in the Vatican II, I'm a little bit afraid to pronounce this word. So what if it was put in Italian? Christine? Aggiornamento, which means updating the church. That's the mantra word of the Second Vatican Council. So, first session, we will go through developments in theology and church since the Vatican II to today. Second, we will then look at our local context, the developments that has been taking place here in the Archdiocese of Suva. So that's both of those two sessions about updating us, especially for the younger ones. We did not know what took place earlier on. And then we'll, session three and four, sessions that have to do with the fundamentals of faith, the mission of God. What is the mission of God? That is the bottom line about why we are here as church. So we want to go back to some of the fundamentals of faith. For us Christians, our medium of knowing God is Jesus Christ. So that is another fundamental one. We want to go back to the fundamentals of the Christian faith. And that is Jesus, the historical Jesus. So those two sessions bring us to the fundamentals of faith. God and how we come to know God through Jesus. And then the last four sessions, we deal with some of the moral, well, really the science of the times is something that developed out of the Vatican II and has developed over the years. Actually, the Saint John the 23rd, that was his word in the Vatican, really in the science of the time. And over the years, we've developed Catholic social principles to deal with the science of the time. So that's one of the sessions. And then the last three sessions, 6, 7, 8, we really want to talk about some of the current issues that the church needs to address. Globalization, climate change, environment, and our doctrine for that would be biodiversity. But also bringing in something that Pope Francis talks about, and that is the indigenous spirituality. Finally, especially because this day is the election, and we need to talk a little bit about the prophetic vocation of the church. What do we hope to accomplish? Strategic plan, shared vision, mission, goals, pastoral initiatives and plans, provide a spiritual awakening in their diocese, and some directions or legislation for the diocese. So those, that's a very brief overview what we will, what the synod is about and what we will do. Again, thank you very much for your attendance in big numbers, and I really want to take this opportunity to sincerely thank you for making this synod now.
Thank you, Grace. I'd like to take this time that you introduce our presenters for the 3-day seminar we will be having. First, when he first smiled at the world at Lower Heart in Attenborough, New Zealand in 1947, and is the first of 5 children to marry and have Eric Gibbs. St. Peter and Paul Primary was his first school, followed by Morris Intermediate and St. Bernard College in Lower Heart. He had a normal, for him, a normal upbringing at the time was with scouts, rugby, church tramping, motorcycles, old cars, guns and the rest. In 1966, he went to the Holy Name Seminary, Christchurch, and then studied for a BA, majoring in sociology at the Canterbury University. In 1971, saw him traveling to Australia to join the Divine Word, missionaries, and after his admission here, studying postgraduate anthropology at the Sydney University. After a year and a half of serving in Papua New Guinea, he spent 4 years studying theology at the Catholic Theological Union in Chicago and returned to New Zealand for ordination as a priest in 1978. Since then, he has served in various capacities in Papua New Guinea as parish priest, director of pastoral center, seminary lectures, and researcher, and his time away between 1989 and 1995. To study for an ascension and then a doctorate in theology at the Gregorian University in Rome. Ladies and gentlemen, please help me welcome Father Philip Gibbs. Our second presenter is probably someone who is known to most of us, but was born in 1955 and is from the Pacific Islands and is a Fiji citizen. He joined the Jesuits in Micronesia in 1994. Has a very, very long career in education, both before joining the society and afterwards. He completed a master's degree in educational administration, Christianity and culture, and in divinity. At Gonzaga University in Spokane, Washington, he completed a doctorate in leadership studies with his thesis on a pastoral approach to church leaders in the Pacific. He is especially alert to questions of culture, cultural differences, and the way these realities affect spirituality and religious practices. He has interest in pastoral adaptation and renewal, questions which are central to the program he once was in the East Asia Pastoral Institute in Manila. Again, let us welcome Father Legend. the third presenter has said that he does not believe in Archbishop because he's well known to you and himself, the Archbishop. Okay, without further ado, you are listening to me. I know my values.
Church from Vatican II to 2018, and